Hello viewers, welcome to the course of Electrical Estimating and Contracting MSBT code 22627 program Electrical Engineering Unit 1 Electrical Wiring Diagram. In this unit, we will see the subtopic scope and features of National Electrical Code 2011 NEC 2011. Teach by Mr. Sachin Radekar, HOD, Electrical Engineering. The course outcome and the learning outcome. Course outcome is interpret various electrical diagrams. Learning outcome, describe the requirements of NEC 2011 related to the given electric installation. Scope and features of National Electrical Code 2011. This code, India's first National Electrical Code, formulated in 1985. The code excludes guidance on tariff. NEC provides guidelines for electrical installation and equipment in location where a hazardous atmosphere is likely to be present, with a view to maximizing electrical safety. The design of electrical installation is required to take into account the characteristics of available supply, nature of demand, environmental condition, type of wiring and method of installations, protective equipment, emergency control, disconnecting devices, preventing of mutual influence between electric and non-electric installation, accessibility, etc. In this write of scope and features of National Electric Code 2011, the next point is non-industrial building include domestic dwellings, office building, shopping and commercial center and institution, recreational and assembly building, medical establishment, hostel and sports building. तो ये सब जो चीजें है दैट कम्स अंडर द नॉन इंडस्ट्रियल मीन्स दिस बिल्डिंग इंक्लूड इसमें आती है ऑफिस शॉपिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स कमर्शियल सेंटर्स मेडिकल एस्टेब्लिशमेंट एंड द स्पोर्ट्स बिल्डिंग एज पर एनईसी 2011 सेकंड वन इज इंडस्ट्रियल इंस्टॉलेशन हैज टू टेक केयर ऑफ द लोड रिक्वायरमेंट एंड सप्लाई लिमिटेशंस इन अ सिंपल एंड इकोनॉमिक मैनर ensuring at the same time full protection to human life and loss of property by fire. So industrial installation jo hai usme jo bhi load aap connect karte ho so it has some economic and the technical limitation. So this is covered under the NEC 2011. In this slide of scope of National Electric Code 2011. The National Electric Code cover the following. First one is standard good practices for selection of various items of electrical equipment forming part of power system. Second one is recommendation concerning safety and related matter in the wiring of electrical installation of building or industrial structure. Promoting compatibility between such recommendation and those concerning the equipment installed. Third one is general safety procedures and practice in electrical work. Fourth one is additional precautions to be taken for use of electrical equipment for special environmental conditions like explosive and active atmosphere. So these are the four scope for National Electrical Code. Main point is covered in this slide. The National Electric Code applies to electrical installations such as those in standby emergency generating plant and building substations. Second one is domestic dwellings. Third, office building, shopping and commercial centers and institution. Fourth is recreation and other public premises. Next is medical establishment, hotels, sports building, industrial premises, temporary and permanent outdoor installations, agricultural premises, installation in hazardous areas, and solar photovoltaic installation. So these are the various electrical installation where this NEC is applicable. National Electric Code 2011 is applicable. As per NEC 2011, the minimum nominal cross-sectional area of the conductor. So, in first column, this is the types of wiring system, then use of circuit and the conductor material with their cross-sectional area. The first one is cables and insulator conductor used for lighting circuit, power circuit, signaling and control circuit. For lighting circuit, the copper material is used and the area is 1.5 mm square. For power circuit, again for copper conductor, it is 2.5 mm square. For signaling and control circuit, aluminium material is used and the area is 10 mm square. For copper, it is 0.5 mm square. Second one is the bare conductor, in which this bare conductor is used for the power circuit and signaling and control circuit. For power circuit, copper material is used and the area is the 10 mm square. For signaling and control circuit, aluminium is used and the area is the 16 mm square. And for signaling and control circuit, if you use copper, then for copper material, 4 mm square is required. Third one is flexible connections with insulated conductor and cables. For specific appliances, copper is used, so the area is 0.5. For any other application, extra low voltage circuit, for special application, then copper material is used and the area required is the 0.5 mm square. In this slide, as per NEC, the distance from electric lines is given in the following table. This table, here in this column, types of supply line is given, then voltage level is given, then vertical clearance and the horizontal clearance. For medium and the low voltage line, the vertical clearance is 2.5 meter and the horizontal clearance is 1.2 meter. Secondly, for high voltage line, up to and including 11,000 volt, the vertical clearance is 3.7 and the horizontal clearance is 1.2. For the high voltage line, above 11 kV up to and including 33 kV, the vertical clearance is 3.7 and the horizontal clearance is 2. For extra high voltage line, the vertical clearance is 3.7 and the horizontal clearance is 2. So this table represents the distance of electric lines. So in this slide, as per NEC 2011, the determination of the load of an installation. जो भी लोड आपके घर में कनेक्टेड होता है, वो लोड का जो कैलकुलेशन है, मींस जो वैटेज रेटिंग है, वो किस तरीके से सिलेक्ट करना है. The following rating may be assumed unless the values are known or specified. अगर जो भी इक्विपमेंट आप इंस्टॉल कर रहे हो, उसकी वैल्यू अगर आपको पता नहीं है, then for calculation you can assume this wattage rating for the connected devices. So in this table, in first column you have written the connected devices and in rating the calculated connected load is given. So first devices is the fluorescent lamp. Here the rating for calculating the connected load is 40 watt. Second one is incandescent lamp and the fan. The rating is 60 watt. For connected devices is 6 ampere socket outlet. The rating is taken as the 100 watt unless the actual value of loads are specified. For 16 ampere socket outlet, 1000 watt unless the actual value of loads are specified. Then next is the exhaust fan fluorescent RAM. Other than single RAM, compact fluorescent RAM, HVMB RAM, HVSV RAM means high voltage mercury vapor RAM and high voltage sodium vapor RAM. So in this, according to their capacity and control gear losses shall also be considered as applicable. तो ये जो टेबल इसमें गिवन है कि अगर फ्लोरोसेंट रैम, इनकंडेसेंट रैम, 6 एम्पियर या 16 एम्पियर सॉकेट, एग्जॉस्ट फैन, इसका अगर रेटिंग गिवन नहीं है, देन फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द कनेक्टेड लोड यू कैन अज्यूम दिस स्टैंडर्ड रेटिंग विच इज गिवन इन दिस टेबल. सो समरी ऑफ द टूडेज लेक्चर इज वी लर्न द नेशनल इलेक्ट्रिक कोड NEC 2011. In this, we have learned the scope of NEC 2011, minimal nominal cross-sectional area of conductor for aluminium as well as the copper for particular application, then distance of electric line in which high voltage line, low voltage line and extra high voltage line, what is the vertical and horizontal clearance we have seen, then determination of the load of an installation. If you have to calculate the load but the specification is not known, then as per NEC you have to assume the load as given in the table. This is the program outcome. Here 7 POs are mapped for this lecture. Thank you very much student for listening the lecture on the National Electric Code, and happy e-learning. Thank you very much.